Welcome to Learning Hotspot. So friends, in this video we are going to discuss what is buffers and what are isotonic solutions. So let's start. So here the topic on your screen. In buffer solution, we are going to discuss what are definition of buffer solution, buffer equation, buffer capacity, buffer in biological system, and then pharmaceutical buffers. And after that we are going to discuss isotonic solution, in which we cover introduction, isoosmotic solution, isotonic solution, and method of adjusting tonicity. So we move ahead with the buffer solution. So first, definition of buffers. So buffers are the mixtures of compound that resist change in pH. So it minimizes the pH. Suppose we have a solution. So the pH of the buffer is 10.01 and this bottle is 4.01 and 7. So suppose we have a buffer solution, if we add acid, so the pH does not decrease. It only decreases to some extent. So it means if we add any weak acid or weak base in any buffer solution, the pH cannot change. It's called buffer solution. So the definition of buffers is, they are the mixture of compound that resist the change in pH, okay, which oppose the change in pH, you can say, upon the addition of small quantity of acid and or alkali or base. So buffer is a compound of weak acid and its salt conjugate base. We discussed on our previous video what is conjugate acid and what are conjugate base, so you can watch if you want. And after that we have a buffer equation. Buffer equation is also be known as Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. So this is a reaction, KaH3OAc upon my HAc. So when HAc is dissociate into H3O positive plus my Ac, and NaC is dissociate into Na positive and Ac negative. So this is a result. So for acid, pH is equal to pKa log salt upon my acid, and for base, there is a pKa plus my log base upon salt. So after that guys, there is a numerical. So what is the pH of solution containing 0.1 molar acetic acid and 0.1 molar sodium acetate? So guys, pKa Ka is given in this numerical. So we put that value in our pKa formula, which is minus log Ka. And after putting and observing the log table, we find the value is 4.76. So we put 4.76 in the formula for buffer equation. So from this equation, we find the pH of buffer solution. After that, the second example we have, how much sodium acetate should be added in 100 ml of 0.1 normal acetic acid solution to prepare buffer of pH 5.2. pKa is given, so same from pKa we put right 4.76 exactly on a buffer equation. So the pH is 5.2 and pKa is 4.76. both values are given after salt upon acid. Acid is also given on the numerical, 0.1. so we only calculate the concentration of salt. So this is for 1 liter, and for 100 ml we find out by multiplying it with 0.01. so this is a result. So this is the concentration of sodium acetate. After that we have a third question. What is pH of solution containing ephedrine 0.1 molar and ephedrine HCl 0.1 normal? Kb of ephedrine is given 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 5. So we put these value in the buffer equation, and the pH of solution will be calculated. After that, another interesting topic had come. What is buffer capacity? So the capacity of buffer is buffer capacity. So how can we write that in our exam? So the buffer capacity is the quantity of strong acid or base that must be added to change the pH of 1 liter of buffer solution by 1 unit. So the quantity of strong acid or base that must be added to the solution or the pH of 1 liter. The quantity of buffer is 1 liter. So the pH of buffer change by 1 unit, 7 to 8 or 7 to 6. Okay. So this is a buffer capacity. After that, we have a buffer capacity formula, which is B is equal to delta B upon delta pH. Delta B is the number of moles of strong acid, and delta pH is change in pH. So after that, new equation has come out, which is exact equation B is equal to 2.3 C Ka H3O positive upon Ka plus H3O positive ka whole square. So this is used for numericals. So friends, we have a numerical of buffer capacity. So at a hydrogen ion concentration of 1.75 into 10⁻⁵, what is capacity of buffer? Means we have to find out the buffer capacity containing 0.1 mole each of acetic acid and the sodium acetate per liter of solution. So Ka is given, concentration is given, and after that H3O positive concentration is also given. So we put them in our equation, which is B is equal to 2 minus 2.3 C. The concentration C is a concentration. The concentration is calculated by adding acid plus salt concentration, so it is 0.2. Okay, so buffer capacity is calculated by this formula. This is a formula of maximum buffer capacity when pH is equal to pKa and the value is come is 0.56 C. So this is another question in which we're gonna find out maximum buffer capacity. The concentration is given, we put that value in our equation. Friends, do you know we have a buffer in our body? So we have two examples of buffers that we have in our body. So the first one is tears, okay, and which have a pH range 7 to 8 with the higher buffer capacity, so that reasonably wide range pH range of medicine can be tolerated. Okay, so the it tells about the eye drops. Okay, so first example is tears, and the second example is our blood. So blood is blood has pH of 7.4, and they maintain its pH by various component in the plasma, bicarbonate, phosphate buffers, ferritic, hemoglobin. So these are the ions that are present in our blood. So you remember this. After that, we have many pharmaceutical preparations of buffers like Eno, which neutralize our stomach HCl. So when we make any pharmaceutical buffer, we have to remember these four points: that it have minimal tissue irritation, so it didn't irritate any tissue, optimum therapeutic effect, means they effectively dissociate in our body and effectively work in our body, maximum drug stability, so they less contaminate, and the last one is maximum drug solubility. So these are the four points that we have to remember while we make any pharmaceutical buffer. So after that, friends, the second part of our video, and that is isotonic solution, has been started. So first we're going to discuss what is introduction of isotonic solution. So in introduction, there is isoosmotic solution. When two solution, iso means same, osmotic mean osmotic pressure, means two solution have same osmotic pressure, have equal osmotic pressure. Okay, so they are separated by the perfect semi-membrane membrane. You saw in the diagram, the two solution are separated by the membrane, and the particles didn't move to each other, so they are separated. So after that, we have what is isotonic solution. So two osmotic pressure, that contain solute which do not cross each other. So this is the definition of isotonic solution that cannot cross the biological membrane. They are described as isotonic. So what? So after that, tonicity. Tonicity is a concentration of only solute that cannot cross the membrane, since this solute exerts osmotic pressure on the membrane. So it is the tonicity is the concentration. We have to maintain the tonicity of a solution before inject in our blood. So when we take any glucose to the human body, we have to maintain its tonicity. So we can discuss the method of adjusting tonicity of any solution. These are the method. The first one is sodium chloride concentration added to drug. So by the two ways we adjust tonicity. First by adding NaCl means salt, and second method is by adding water. So by adding NaCl have two method, cryoscopic method and NaCl equivalent method. Okay, and when we add water under this, we have two method, White Vincent method and Spall's method. So these are the method of adjusting tonicity. So thank you guys. If you like this video, press like button, subscribe to this channel if you want to get more stuff like this, and if you have any suggestion, you can comment in the comment section below. Thank you.